Hi everyone, it's Lucy from My Crazy Craft Life, and today I'm here with a design team post for Scrapping for Less. Today I'm going to be making this trifold card, and it's a little bit more than just a simple trifold card, and it's not one of the easiest fun folds I've ever done, but it's certainly manageable to do. I used the September Flavor of the Month card kit. And I tried to use as much from the kit as I possibly could. I wanted to get kind of all the different elements in it. And to start off, you're going to start off with a card base that is 5.5 inches by 12 inches. And then you're going to have a small card that's going to go inside that is 5 inches by 7 inches. And then you're just going to simply score it right in half. And that's going to be the card that goes on the inside. Now, here is what you're going to do and how you're going to make the card base. You are going to start by scoring on the 12-inch side at 4 inches and 8 inches. So that's it for that. Now you're going to turn it around and you are going to cut a portion of it. Now, whichever side you end up working on is the same side you're going to cut in both areas. And if you put your marker on your trimmer, or you go down 5 inches, you're going to cut to 11 inches, and you're going to put the card base itself at 4 3/4 inches and at 3/4 inch. So you're just going to make two cuts from 5 inches to 11 inches, both 3/4 inch down. Now this card is going to fit perfectly into a normal A2 size envelope. Now you are going to score additionally. And you're going to score them at the 5-inch mark, the 6.5-inch mark, the 8-inch, which is already there because of your score line, the 9.5-inch mark, and then the 11-inch mark. But you're only scoring in between the cut lines. So you are not scoring all the way the entire length of the card. You're only scoring from score line to score line. Cut line to cut line. And that's going to create kind of an accordion in the back of this. Now I'm going to get a little pair of scissors and I'm just going to snip, because you do want to make sure that the line is cut from score line to score line, from the 5-inch mark all the way through to the 11-inch. So you don't want to rip it, so you do want to make sure if you need to snip it a little bit more, you do that. Now start folding the card and you're going to score it on the 4-inch line and then the 8-inch line, just mountain and valley, valley and mountain. Now you're going to take the portion on the inside that you cut and you're going to start off with a mountain fold with the very first score line, the 5-inch score line, go to a valley fold. The mountain fold is there because of the 8-inch score line. The next part is a valley fold, and the final one is a mountain fold. Now, it's not going to fold like this because you see it doesn't really fit like that. However, that's how it's going to look after you finish folding everything. But it will fold in half the same way to be able to fit in that standard size envelope. Now, because a normal A2 size card is 5.5 by 4.25, this is only 4 inches wide, but this is a very thick card, especially when you do lots of layers. So you're gonna have that extra room and it will fit perfectly, that I'll show you at the end. Now, the pieces that you'll need are the front panel and the inside panel are going to be 5 1/4 inches by 3 3/4 inch. The front panel for the card is 4 3/4 by 3 1/4. The front stripe on the front of the card, that's really on the inside of the front panel, is 5 1/4 inches by 1 1/4 inches. Now, all of these little strips, you're going to need two strips that are going to go on the outside edges that I just placed down there, that are going to be 3 3/4 by 3/4 inch. You're going to need four strips that are 3 3/4 by 1/2 inch, and those are the black or the dark brown with the green leaves. And then you are going to need four strips, and those are the inside panels, that are 3 3/4 by 1 1/4 inch. and that will fit into all of those areas. The rest of this is pretty much just decorating the card how you want it and what you want to do. How you want to place panels, what you want to add to it. Like I said, I was trying to use a lot of stuff from this kit. So I used the twine that was part of the kit. I am going to pop this up with some foam tape so that it's a more even background for it. So with the twine in there, so it's not kind of off sides. Plus I got to use the twine in there. And that card is actually going to go on the inside of the front flap. I am going to cut down this little fence, and then you see I cut it the wrong size, so I'm actually going to have to cut another one. It's a good thing I made a bunch of them. And the stamps, all of the stamps I pre-colored with some alcohol markers, and then I cut them out using my Scan and Cut. And I'm just going to start decorating and kind of going to town with this. Now I used the gnome stamp, I used the little scarecrow, I used the pumpkin stamp. I also used the sunflower stamp on the inside. I used papers from every kit, I believe. Yes, because even on the front I got the pumpkin one in there and stuff. And then I'm just going to kind of start, like I said, going through and just decorating this all. Now, it is a little time consuming to get everything ready. Obviously, coloring all of those images and even using the Scan and Cut and cutting them out, you know, that takes quite a bit of time. But overall, I think this card is a lot simpler than you may think when you start making it, because most of what's on there is just about the decoration, and you can go any way that you want to do with that, for any type of event that you want to make it a card for or anything like that. Now I'm going to add this card onto the back of the front panel, or the front of the card, but on the back side of it. So it's actually going to be a little card within a card. And that's kind of how it will sit open. And I decided with the fence and everything to kind of make a little scene. And I used the papers that are part of this to kind of help me create that scene that I wanted to make. So even though it's a little different as far as with the flowers in the background and stuff, I still think it makes a fun scene at the end. And what's also fun about this is it gives you a lot of room to be able to put not only all different stamps and ephemera and stickers, whatever you might have to use, but it also gives you a lot of leeway as to what you're going to do with it and how you're going to make it. I actually had my score line a little bit off when I created this on one of the score lines that I made, and it still ended up working out perfectly. So being 100% exactly precise isn't going to completely ruin your card because it wasn't 100% correct. You have a little bit of leeway into this. Now, I was trying to use the pieces from the dies that I had made, and I had made those in a previous video, and I had some left, so I was going to use those. I liked the fence. I liked the effect of the little fence. I thought it was really cute. I popped up the image of that scarecrow, and I popped up the sentiment that's on there that says, "Hey there, pumpkin," and I thought that was cute for the front. Now on the inside, I'm going to kind of start playing with this. Now I had told you I cut that fence wrong, so I am going to actually kind of use it and just piece it together so that you don't even really realize that I cut it in half unless I tell you, like in this video, because I'm going to pop that gnome right over it so you won't even see it. And then I did end up finding a way to use the die cuts there. And like I said, this is just a really fun card. It just, you can make so many different themes. And even though everything isn't the same, and I have sunflowers in there, and I have the other types of flowers, I have the pumpkin stuff, you know, it's all a fall card, and I just think it was so much fun creating this card. And like I said, there's just so much that you can do with it. Now, instead of using black or VersaFine ink like I normally would for not only the stamp that was inside of the card, the sunflower stamp, on the outside I even did some stuff with the Mocha from Your Next Stamp ink cube, and that's what I had used on there. Now, like I said, a lot of this is just kind of piecing things together. I knew I wanted to use a bunch of the parts from the card or from the card kit or as much as I could. But this was really just kind of laying everything out in front of me, laying all the images down and seeing what I wanted to use, where I wanted to use them, how I wanted to use them, and just kind of piecing them together as I went. So I just colored, cut them out, laid all of the things. So I used enamel dots, I used the ribbons, I used the twine, I used some of the ephemera. And I like how it's cut out there, and it gives you some really cool ways that you can set things up. So if you look here, after I put my images down in front of the fence, like I said, this is going to be thick because there's a lot of stuff there. I can still put some stuff on the side there that are going to kind of stick out, and it's not going to affect how the card folds. So again, you have a lot of leeway as to how you can, you know, place things on this and where they can stick out and stuff like that. Now, I did want to use this bow because I love this ribbon and I thought it was so pretty, but I just couldn't make it work the way I wanted it to work. It's just a little bit too large with all the other stuff that I already have on there. So what I ended up doing is creating a double bow with the other ribbon that is part of this kit, that kind of purplish burgundy ribbon, and that is what I'm going to end up putting in the front. And after this is pretty much it for the card. I hope you enjoyed this. I hope to see a bunch of people making these, because I would love to see what other people come up and how they come up with and how they decorate them. I think this is such a fun card and just gives you so many different options of what you can do for this. And like I said, it still fits perfectly in the A2 size envelope when it's all folded up. And it's pretty simple. It makes a nice piece that you can actually sit out and have an entire little scene there. And it does slide in there. And like I said, with the thickness of this card, it kind of works perfect with those envelopes. So I appreciate you guys sticking around and watching this. I hope you enjoyed the video. Head over to Scrapping for Less and check it out. And again, this is from the September 2020 Flavor of the Month card kit. Thanks. Have a great day, everybody. Stay safe. Thank you.